what they used to do is, okay, you give them the same question paper and tell them, okay, come next week, we will take the question answer. I mean, you have to write the answer for that. And most of the children, they are not able to write in spite of getting the question paper. And this is what will happen in the Akhirah also. How? They will not be able to write the answers in spite of the fact they have got the questions and they have got the manual of instructions, that is Quran, to write it. Now, those who are wise, like you, because you studied well, passed 9th also and came to 10th, and if you study well, you will go to 11th and 12th also. It depends, because it depends upon you. How do you act and how do you behave? That is the most important part. See, the world is open with you and the entire life depends on you. You are the people, you are the maker of your destiny, nobody else. So certain things we will be discussing here, okay, how you will make up your life. What are the fundas, what are the formulas which you can apply and progress well, not only in this world, but at the same time, your Akhirah. During these Saturday lectures, you will get a lot of exposure, but it will depend. I'll discuss these things later. Now, what is the most important part to be successful? What is the most important part to be successful in life or in the Akhirah? What is that? You should have a desire to be successful. Willingness, that should come from within. Yes, I should do something. If that desire is not there, you know, if you don't want to do something, it is not possible. See, in the Quran itself, the moment you start the Quran, and very few verses are there. Alif Lam Mim Zalikal Kitabu La Rayba Fi Hudal Lil Muttaqin. There are 6 conditions laid down in the Quran. Those who follow those conditions, they will only get the hidayat from the Quran. Not everybody. Hudal Lil Muttaqin means what? Ke hidayat is for those who want it, who are really nek. It is only for those who want it. If you want to read Quran with different intention, with different something, that okay, I'll just read it for my knowledge. Knowledge is not going to help you. You have to be willing to accept the guidance given by Quran. That desire should be there. Yes, I should be successful in Akhirah. I should be successful in this life. The complete manual of instructions is given in Quran. What is the manual of instructions? Anything you go and buy, along with that, one manual instruction is coming. And for example, you take any iPhone or anything, so instruction manual is coming along with this. You read it and accordingly you operate. So you are able to operate the things, even if it is technically very sophisticated or anything, you are able to operate. Similarly, the Quran is. How you should spend your life in this world, it is given in Quran. So to be successful in life, you should have the desire. Desire to be successful. Desire to be successful in Akhirah. Desire to be successful in this life. And those who have the desire, they will only succeed. This is the number one condition. Number one condition is, you should have the desire to succeed, to proceed. Then you will be successful. Otherwise, not possible. And there we have several examples. Like Allah Ta'ala says, it is a Hadith Qudsi. What he says? Allah Ta'ala says, if you come towards me one foot, I'll come to you 10 feet. If you come to me by walking, I'll come to you by running. But who has to take the initiative? It is a person who wants it. If you go to him, then only Allah Ta'ala will come. But he will come 10 times faster than what you are doing. That is the condition. This is the Hudus-e-Qudsi. Hudus-e-Qudsi is what? The certain things told by Allah himself to the Prophet Muhammad, and he ultimately conveyed it to us. Allah Ta'ala says something like this. That is known as Hadith-e-Qudsi. So in that it is very clear, if you take initiative, then Allah Ta'ala helps you. And whichever way you want to go, Allah Ta'ala will not stop you. You know, you are a Muslim, so don't go on this path. This is wrong. No, this is only the test. He has given you the power of choice to decide in which direction you want to go. And whichever direction you choose, doors will get open in that direction. Very important, very crucial for all of you. If you want to go towards a good, then doors will get open. And if you want to go towards bad things, doors will get open. But only thing, in both the cases, Allah Ta'ala will help those who are good and they want to do good for the humanity, for themselves, for their own self, and ultimately they want to build up their akhirah also. So willingness to do something, desire is the most important part, which people should do it. Is that clear? Now, similarly, you must have seen in the Battle of Badr, what happened? Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he prepared 313 sahabas, made them ready, whatever the equipments and the arms and ammunition they had, very few, two, three, something like, you know, horses, swords and so many, whatever, it was very less. And opponent, they were 1,000. 1,000 opponents were there. And there they had to face. But ultimately, whatever the strength he could gather and collect, that he'd put it in the Battle of Badr, and then he started praying to Allah. Similarly, Sheikh Saadi Rahmatullah Alayh, he said one saying in Urdu, I'll tell you, what is that saying? Apne hisse ka kaam kiye bagair, dua pe bharosa karna himakat hai. Apne hisse ka kaam kiye bagair, dua pe bharosa karna himakat hai. Aur apne qabiliyat pe bharosa karke, dua se gurez karna takabur hai. And ultimately, you will get success with the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala only. But you have to work hard. You have to put in your best efforts. Then pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He will help you. This is the funda you have to adopt to be successful in both the lives, in this life and in the hereafter. Now comes E plus R is equal to O. This is the formula number one. Formula number one is what? E plus R is equal to O. What happens? You will be surprised in the classroom, rather in whole Mumbai or whole Maharashtra, same syllabus is being taught to all the students. Or you take the example of your class. Same teacher, same syllabus, same books, and all of you sitting in the class and being taught. But when the result comes, it varies. One person is getting above 95% and few are getting below 35%. What is the reason? How does it happen? What is the reason? Why does it happen? Because it is this formula, E plus R is equal to O, whereas the E says what? This is the event. E stands for event. This is an event is happening here. Okay, I am speaking the same language to all of you, but the response from all of you will differ. And R stands for response. And depending upon your response will be the output. How much attentive you are, how much you are grasping what I am telling you, how much response you are giving to it, accordingly your output will be. That's the reason I am telling you. Most of the students, they don't give good response in the classroom, and therefore the result varies. Some of the students, those who understand the seriousness of studies, they pay a lot of attention in the class and they do understand what is being taught, what is happening in the class. Whereas many students, they don't respond, they don't give proper response, they don't even understand, they are somewhere else, they are busy doing something else, and the result is output differs. This is the formula for your E plus R is equal to O. Now this is success we are talking about. Okay, you have to be successful in the akhirah, ultimate goal, and in this world. Now in this world, the success is divided into six parts mainly. Mainly it is divided into six parts. What are those? Health, family, wealth, spiritual, mental, career, and social, society. On these topics, we will be discussing things later on, inshallah, in the days to come, okay, how this one by one, how you should be able to achieve these things. Today, it is just a being introduction to the forthcoming sessions. It is being introduced to you, okay, what are the things you will be learning in the days to come.